Welcome. My name is Ryatea, and in February of 2021, Sean Goebel and I spent 5 days in Yosemite to capture the Horsetail Falls Firefall from the Valley Rim, a location that not many people have photographed the firefall from. So in this video, I'm going to share with you some of my photos and some quick videos from the trip. We're out here at Badger Pass, and we're going to begin our five-day, five-night backpacking trip to photograph the firefalls from the crater rim. So, Sean has the sled. I have a backpack. We're a quarter of the way there, and it's been an hour and 15 minutes. And our first snack break. We've been snowshoeing all the way. There's just a ridiculous amount of snow on this outhouse. That's how much snow that we're walking through. We're about 5 miles in, and we're taking our second snack break. And our feet are getting heavier and heavier. Well, I'm pulling the sled now, giving Sean a break. But thankfully it stopped raining and it's kind of clearing up. And look at this wonderful view. Well, we're finally getting a little bit of sunlight and a little bit of blue sky, which is so nice to see. We each took 1 liter of water and we ran out, so now we're melting snow. I'm gonna use that. Well, it just started snowing and we have 3 more miles to Glacier Point, so we better get going. We had to connect the sled to both of us for the downhill section. The conditions were not ideal. It was slightly above freezing and raining. My snowshoes were sinking in the snow 6 to 10 inches each step, even with my snowshoe extenders on. So by the time we reached Glacier Point, I was almost about ready to pass out from exhaustion. Well, last night we came in at 8 p.m. and that's after 10 hours of hiking, so it was quite brutal. One of the most difficult hikes I've ever done, but finally made it to Glacier Point, and this morning it's not bad. This is all the gear we're bringing. We have 4 bodies plus 2 outside, tons of lenses, a lot of telephoto lenses, and 5 tripods in total. So we're leaving Glacier Point and we're heading to Roosevelt Point. We made it to Roosevelt Point and we can have a great view of Al Capitan and all the way over here. We have a view of Yosemite Falls. So we're gonna take a rest. We're gonna figure out what compositions we're gonna use and then we're gonna wait till sunset to capture the firefalls. Just around here. Well, we just had the firefall, but some clouds blocked it just at sunset, so we couldn't get quite the pictures we wanted, but we'll give it another try tomorrow. Well, we thought we had no firefall tonight, but a few minutes after the sun went down, the whole thing lit up red. So it was quite the surprise.
Well, it's the next morning, and last night we hiked back to our camp at Glacier Point, and then we set up some cameras to shoot the moonset on Half Dome. It's the next morning, and this is how it looks of Yosemite Falls through my 500mm lens. We are packing up, and we're gonna head out to Sentinel Dome for the day. We're gonna try to get some pictures in the Yosemite webcam itself, just to have a little bit of fun. So we're all packed up and we're gonna move camp to Sentinel Dome. Today is looking more like a cloudy day, so we might not be able to capture the firefall, but we might have a nice sunset. So we came from Glacier Point and hiked to Sentinel Dome to set up our new camp, and we even have the luxury of having a bench and table. We're back on Sentinel Dome to shoot sunset. We're cooking up dinner. So it's either gonna be a dud or it's gonna be a nice sunset. There looks to be a space between the horizon for the sun to shine through, so that's what we're hoping. And of course the firefall would be the cherry on top. Last night we had a great sunset and the firefalls. So today we're gonna head back to Padre Pass, and we got up early to start packing up camp. Well, we're back at Padre Pass, and it basically took half the time that it took for us to hike in. So it took 5 hours for us to hike out, which is quite impressive. But we're gonna spend the day in the valley and see what we can capture. You can't visit Yosemite without stopping at Half Dome, at the tunnel view, Just one of the most beautiful lookouts in the park.
Well, our last day in the valley ended up being cloudy, but it was a very successful trip overall. It's not hard to see why not a lot of people come to the valley rim to photograph the firefall. Hiking 10 miles through the snow and camping in sub-freezing temperatures just isn't fun, but it was definitely worth it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time.